Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common BMW S54 engine problems. The BMW S54 was the last naturally aspirated inline-six engine to power the BMW M3, so by the time the BMW E46 M3 and S54 engines had come out, BMW had nearly perfected the naturally aspirated inline-six design. The S54 delivered incredible performance for its time, with 333 horsepower here in the United States from its 3.2-liter design, so breaking that 100 horsepower per liter number at the very start of the 2000s era was very impressive performance, and BMW also did a great job of balancing that with good reliability on the S54. However, all engines are still prone to their fair share of problems, and there aren't any exceptions here with the BMW S54. So let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common BMW S54 engine problems. At number one on the list here, we have issues with the Vanos system. The variable valve timing system, known as Vanos by BMW, is something that has been a common problem on many different BMW engines, especially as they get older and break that 100,000 mile mark. Fortunately, on many modern BMW engines, issues really just boil down to the Vanos solenoids, which are easy to access, relatively inexpensive, and very simple repairs. However, that wasn't quite the case with the BMW S54 and some of the older engines. These Vanos systems were a little bit more complicated just because it was newer technology back then near the introduction of the S54 in 2000. It does have a couple different issues that can affect the Vanos system. Those include problems with the camshaft sprocket bolts, the exhaust camshaft hub, the Vanos oil pump, as well as the solenoids. Now, when it comes to the Vanos oil pump and the solenoids, unfortunately, these are complicated problems and typically require replacing the entire Vanos unit. And replacing the entire unit runs about $1,500 through Dr. Vanos, which is one of the most well-known and best brands for a lot of these Vanos rebuilds on older engines, including the BMW S54. There is a core charge there, so I think it comes down to about $1,100 or $1,200 in total to get one of those rebuilt Vanos units. A little bit more of an expensive issue. Again, a few different things with the Vanos system that can go wrong that lead to replacing the entire Vanos unit is really the easiest solution. One thing to keep in mind there, ultimately, this is going to be one of the most common BMW S54 engine problems, but even though it can be a little bit of a pricier repair, it's still a pretty minor issue in the grand scheme of things. Moving on to the second most common problem, we have water pump failure. Water pumps are really something that fail and are problematic on just about any BMW engine in its history. It's pretty common for all BMW water pumps to fail around that 70 to 100,000 mile ballpark. And that is exactly the case with the water pump on the S54 3.2-liter inline-six engine. Something to be on the lookout for. Fortunately, on the S54 and really any older BMW engine in general, the water pumps and parts are a lot cheaper than they are on most modern BMW engines. So if you're looking to replace the water pump and thermostat, it's going to be about $150 to $250 in parts for the OEM water pump and thermostat. So if you're DIYing it, really not too bad of a repair job and a bill there. But if you do end up at a repair shop, that will add another roughly $400 to $600 in labor. And depending where you go, they might charge you closer to MSRP for the parts. So it could still end up being an $800 job if you do go to a repair shop. Moving on to the third most common problem, we have rod bearing failures. Rod bearing failures are a very serious problem. So it's something worth mentioning just because issues with the rod bearing can result in complete engine failure at the worst, or in the best case scenario, can still lead to very costly repair bills and potentially needing to rebuild or partially rebuild the S54. Rod bearing failures did primarily affect 2001 until 2003 models. I believe more specifically, it was the E46 M3s. built between February 2001 and May 2003. Ultimately, BMW did address this with a technical service bulletin after in the early days they tried to blow it off and claim that rod bearing problems were due to the faults of owners either over-revving the engine or not using proper oil. BMW did end up owning up to this and offering some solutions and repairs for these rod bearing failures on the 2001 to 2003 models. Any of those design flaws that were from back in those days should have been fixed by now, so this is a smaller problem. However, rod bearings are still one of the most common internal engine problems on the BMW S54, so if you are seriously in the market for an E46 M3 or currently own one with the S54 engine, then it may be a good idea to preventatively replace the rod bearings, or what's probably the better and cheaper solution is simply doing an oil analysis from time to time. A lot of companies like Blackstone Laboratories, for example, you can just send them a sample of your oil. They will then go ahead and do all of the testing, and that can show if there are any materials in the oil, any metals in the oil that would indicate excess rod bearing wear, which will then allow you to at least catch the rod bearing issues in time, get those bearings replaced hopefully before they chew up the crankshaft or cause any further damage. Ultimately, those three issues really wrap up the most common problems for the BMW S54. This is a pretty reliable engine overall, at least it certainly was a reliable engine in its younger days. It is important to point out that this is a roughly 18 to 24 year old engine at this point, and that leaves a lot of room for potential age-related problems. Nothing to hold against the S54 or the M3 in any way. This can be said about any 20-year-old car. It's just a car of that age is prone to a lot of additional problems. Any kind of plastic components, gaskets, O-ring, seals, all of that type of stuff just tends to wear down and degrade with age and mileage. And so definitely a lot more problems nowadays on a 20-year-old engine with the S54 that are fair game. And so it's going to require a little bit of extra TLC and probably have a couple other miscellaneous problems here and there. The S54 is a reliable engine. The water pump failures really aren't a huge deal. That's just something that's common on just about any BMW engine. The Vanos system problems, that is something that can be a little bit costly, but as I mentioned, still a relatively minor issue in the grand scheme, especially considering the S54 is an otherwise very reliable engine. And then lastly, I talked about the rod bearings, which were a problem in the early days that BMW addressed, and one that can still happen, but that can easily be avoided by just sending in your oil for the occasional testing or replacing them preventatively if you really are worried about the bearings failing and causing a complete engine failure. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.